In this video, we're going to show you how to send data from Airtable to make.com using the Airtable scripting extension. If you've watched any of our previous videos, you may have seen that there are four primary ways that you can trigger a scripting bot to fire from within Airtable. We're not going to go over those all here, so check out our YouTube channel if you are interested in one of the other methods. But really quickly, the first two methods happen in the automations panel, where you create an action that is a scripting block, and based on certain conditions, you can trigger that automation, which would trigger the script. The second method would be to create that automation, but instead of the trigger being condition-based or time-based, the trigger is actually a button click on an interface. Those two happen in the automations panel. What we're going to look at today is creating a scripting block in Airtable extensions and then having a button in our data view. So let's get into that and look at how you can send data from Airtable to make.com using the Airtable scripting extension. Here I'm inside my very simple base. There's really not much going on at all. The point here is to show you how you can take data and send it to make.com with the scripting extension. So we have a very simple base. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to add an extension, the scripting block. I'm going to add a button record to my base. And then I'm going to go to make, and I'm going to create a scenario with a webhook, and then I'm going to test. So those are the steps I'm going to go through. Let's get started. So I'm going to come up to my extensions here, and I'm going to add an extension. And the one I want to add is a scripting block. So I'm going to add that extension. You will need to be on a paid plan to use extensions. So that's one thing to know here. I'm going to cancel out of that and delete everything that I have in there. What I've done is I've created a script that you can copy paste from nocodecollab.com. So go to the tutorial page and you can copy this whole script. But I've tried to make this really simple, pasted this in here. Tried to make this really simple in that all you need to do is update two data points at the very top of the script. You don't need to touch anything else. So what it's going to do is we need to put in the webhook that we're about to get from make.com, and then we need to update the table name. So if I X out of this quick, it should be saved. So I've got a table here that is going to be teams. Now, I need to put the table name of the table that contains the records that I want to send to make.com. So if I'm, say I'm creating playing cards, let's say I'm creating playing cards for athletes, then I'd probably want to do this on, I would probably want to put in players as my table name, not teams. But if I'm trying to create a data sheet about the team and all the players and all the stuff, then I would want to put in teams as my table. So I actually like the idea of creating a card, like a trading card. So let's do players. So I'm going to come in here and my table name, if we expand this, my table name is players. So I just update that to players and I will have my webhook in a second. So that's all I need to do right now. I will finish editing and now close that, and I will add a button field. It's at the very bottom and I'm going to call this card automation. And let's call this create card. And the action that I want to do is going to be to run a script. And now I have to select the script because I could have many scripts. So I'm going to go, it's on my dashboard one, as you can see, and it's called scripting. Now, if I wanted to, I can update the name here and I could call this trading card to make.com. And then when you are creating and setting it up, you can see that your extension name has now been updated. And then if I wanted to, I could also change the style. So I want this to be a big blue button. So now you can see there's a field that has a button in it for creating the card. So step one, I've added the extension. Step two, I've created the button. Step three, we're going to head over to make.com and we're going to create a new scenario. So I'm in Make, create my new scenario, and my first module is going to be a webhook. And I'm going to create a new custom webhook. And I'm going to call this Airtable Player Trading Card. And I'm going to save that. Now it's created this address for me, and I'm going to copy that address to my clipboard. I'm going to come back over to my Airtable base. I'm going to edit my code, and right where it says paste webhook here, I'm going to paste that webhook right there. Okay, and now we can finish editing. And now I hit OK, and now if I hit run once, now my webhook is listening. It's listening for data coming from, or data hitting that webhook. And if I hit create card, boom, data sent successfully. And now I can see in my webhook that I got a record ID sent from Airtable to make.com. So now I have added my script, I've added my button, I've added, created a webhook, and I've checked that my data is now at getting and being received by make.com. The next step I need to do is I just want to add an Airtable so I can get all my data in Make. I want to add an Airtable block here, which is going to be get a record. And now I'm going to go to my player's base. Let's see if I can, it's called scripting, excuse me. My scripting base, my player's table, and the record ID that I'm looking for came from the first step. So I'm gonna grab my record ID from this first step. And now what happens is if I run it again, I should see in my data that's received, I should see Justin Jefferson, number 18, he plays for the Vikings, etc. Data sent successfully, I come over here, and now I can see that I've got Justin Jefferson, plays for Nike. And interestingly enough, the team name does not come through because it's a linked record. So there's a way to do that that I get into in another video, but if you want to pass that data through right now without doing the link record thing, what you can do is you can just add a lookup field, and I want to bring the name through. And now my team name is coming through. Team name, which is the Vikings. If I run it again, now I can see that my team name has come through as the Vikings. So I have now successfully set up a scripting block to send data from Airtable to make.com using that Airtable scripting extension. Hopefully you found this tutorial helpful and you now have a very simple way that you can send data from Airtable to make.com using the scripting extension. Be sure to head over to nocodecollab.com and our tutorial page to grab the code snippet so that you don't have to write it all yourself. You only have to replace those two bits of information and the code should work for you no problem. If you found this helpful, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and we will see you at the next tutorial.